Welcome to another Kimberley Adventures. We're going fishing, heading about 100 odd k's south of Broome. Little spot down there, you might all know it. We're meeting up with Ryan. He's from Ocean Addict. Bloody good fisho, good Kimberley fisho. So we're going to meet him up here at the Croc and Bull Bar. We're going to have a couple beers and have something to eat, because by the time we get into camp, no doubt be dark, or nearabouts anyway. So we thought we'd just meet up here and mosey on down. I'll introduce you to him. Yeah, so we're heading down there. We're probably going to go out about 60 odd KL, out to some ground out there, hopefully get hold of some reds and some blue bones. We've got this little window, little weather window. Next 3 days, I think, is going to be pretty good. Coppers just went past. Suppose you're not allowed to do this either. Anyway, yeah, so we're going to meet up with Ryan here and we'll mosey on down. Right, I'll catch up. What? We're in the Kimberleys. So all good trips start here, don't they? The Croc and Bull Bar. Here's the croc. There's the bull. Hey, we're not starving, are we, mate?
No.
Oh, look at that. Well, you can't go wrong. Good chucker.
Never go hungry at the roadhouse.
This is Ryan. He's the fish whisperer of the Kimberley.
Oh, here we go. Talking me up already. We haven't left Broome yet.
We haven't caught a fish yet.
No, we haven't caught a fish yet. We didn't catch a fish last time we went out either, so.
No, we didn't. But this time, with the wind, hopefully it'll all be fucking good. All right. Righto, we got about, I don't know, rowdy mob. About an hour and a half and we'll be at camp. See you there.
There was this friend of mine on murder. When the judge's gavel fell,
well, we made it to the turn off. Here's the man, the legend himself, Shane Healy Broome, Kimberley Adventures. Got the big V8 rig, he'd be stuck behind me putting around at fucking 100k the whole way. About 30 click down the road. is the man, the legend.
Hey.
Stuck behind me doing a hunty the whole way, mate.
Like any good trip, if it hasn't got a red dirt road on it, we're not bloody interested.
There's not even any rain on it. Unbelievable.
That's a good thing. We've been down here sometimes, and you're absolutely surfing down here. No shit. Especially down there in that low line in there.
Oh, it's just like a fucking river, isn't it?
Yeah, I had a mate of mine, Matty Hawk. He was camped out the other side of Biggie Danger and come through this way.
Yeah.
And a big storm came that night, and they decided to pack up, and they were coming along here, and they actually got bogged on this road.
They got bogged on their own. That's hard to do.
Yeah, they did.
Even if you are here and it rains, generally you can get out, can't you?
Yeah.
Even if it's flowing, well, but there's a couple longer, you stay on the road.
That's right. Well, that's what I told him. I said, anywhere in the Kimberleys, if you stay in the middle, it doesn't matter if it's flooded, because that's where the heart is.
Don't go to those floodways and shit, you're in trouble.
If you try to go around it where there's no water, that's where it's soft and you're going to go down.
For sure.
Stay in the middle. Yeah. Always stay in the middle.
So it's usually not that, and it runs off, or just wait and it'll run off in like an hour or two, isn't it?
That's
on the other hand, like the way, bloody, how quick it seeps in.
Yeah. So they were there all night.
All night.
Here we are. We got about, I think it's 20 k's or something like that. Down this little road here. All good fishing trips up here in the Kimberleys. can't go wrong when you're going on a dirt road to get to them, eh? Yeehaw. It looks pretty dry. I think they said they had a bit of rain down this way, but not much. Nothing to worry us anyway. All blue skies at the moment. Beautiful. Right, I'll see you when we get down here. That sun's coming out, but it, through my eyes, looks pretty bloody good. A little bit of cloud cover. Oh, it's cloud or smoke? Might be a bit of both. Right, pretty nice. Let's camp for the night. Next couple of days, anyway.
Fucking hell,
eh?
It's got the...
Oh, the bloody Kimberley secret.
Hey, it's doing the housework.
Gotta earn your keep.
There we go. Doesn't want to put his swag and all that fucking... scorpions and centipedes and shit to be
in
there.
I'm sleeping up in the top tent.
Oh, he's in the tent. He's in the boat. Probably a smart move.
Oh, you got a little crop going here.
Oh, there we go. Grass coming through.
Going for a walk about. Not sure what the time is. It'd have to be 6:30, eh? 6:37? Something like that. How's the colours, though?
5 to 7.
5 to 7.
That is not sort of the last of the light.
Yeah. We got this one little window that we're going to try and fish. And then the big storm's coming in, so in and out mission. But how's the colours? It's not hot, it's beautiful, nice little breeze. Hey, how's that?
There's no fires around, that's just all sort of light cloud, isn't it?
Yeah. That's just bloody awesome. Hope this is coming through. Take one of those bloody panoramics.
see if that comes out pretty now. Right.
Good morning. How are we all? Pretty uneventful night. We had a few beers and watched the moon come up. That's why that moon and that sunset was so good last night. It's the ash cloud from that that volcano. It's made its way over to the west here. Made for pretty interesting moonrise and sunsets. Should be another good one tonight, no doubt. We got no wind, we've got a slight breeze. So it looks like we're going wide. Fingers crossed anyway. Alright, I'll catch you when we're heading down the track and putting the boat in. We're just waiting on tide at the moment. I'll wait a while. Always waiting for something up here, aren't we? Alright, we're just having some brekkie and then should be enough water for us to put this in. Isn't that right, mate?
Yeah, mate. Whatever you said, yes.
Yes, cool.
We got it all ourselves anyway, so we're hoping to get out wide. We're just breaking new ground out there, so we've got like one spot. So it's a long run just for one spot.
Righto, we're just waiting a while for that tide to come in. And then Ryan reckons about an hour out to the spot, depending on the weather, how rough it's going to be out there. Tomorrow's supposed to be pretty pick of the day. And how's this sky? Really weird. All that ash from that bloody volcano, they tell me. That's what Mrs. said this morning. And so it should make for a nice sunset. So we'll come down here and have some sunset drinks like we did last night. Have a look-see. The tide will be right up to here today. So this lagoon is quite nice when the tide's like right in. It's all nice clear water and you can see. Still don't recommend swimming. Still got that big croc hanging out here and stingers as well. I don't know if they get many of the irriganges in this system. They may do. I'll ask Ryan in a minute and he might know. He used to live here and work here. So he knows this area fairly well. Righto, we'll get down to this boat. Yeah, see how quick that tide comes in. That was sitting on the dirt there before. And it's taking me 5 minutes to go and park the car and come back. She's already there. Coming in quick, old mate.
Oh, yeah, it's not messing around. Nah, it's just cracked the seal like a minute ago. Can be floating right about now. Good timing.
Yeah, beautiful.
Good time to launch too, the new punters. When it's like already here, a bit easier.
Yeah. So how long have you been fishing this system through here?
99, we first came up 99.
Yeah.
And I've probably done the last 10 out of the last 20 sort of seasons out here, yeah.
Have you seen any change over that time?
Not too really, not in the fishing wise. I think the fishing's got better or we just got better at it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's probably more likely.
Better gear.
More spots. And the other boat ramp, that was a pain when that closed over.
Yep.
River running through that second ramp.
Yeah.
Get a bit busy here in the season.
Yeah,
with only the one ramp.
Trying to get your boat in, and because you only got so long, you got to get out of the water quick sticks. And when you get some guy mucking around and he's polishing his boat at the ramp,
straps on and everything in the ramp.
And so, come on, mate, you can do that up there.
Going back to Tassie from the ramp. Getting it full ready.
Yeah,
sometimes you do a bit of circle work here in the season.
Yeah.
Your time's coming a bit later than everyone. Yeah. Everyone tends to comes in early.
For you guys that don't know Ryan, he's got a YouTube channel called Ocean Addict. I've got his stickers on the boat over there. All right, Ashley will zoom in, then you can suss it. There you go, check him out, because he knows this country pretty good, and he's a bloody good fisherman. Aren't you, mate?
Oh, yeah.
Just ask you.
After about 5 hours, we'll get a better answer then.
Good stuff.
That we're floating already.
Yeah, righto, we're out of here. I don't know if you can hear that wind. There's a little bit of a slight breeze, but that'll be on our bum on the way out, maybe a bit of a cross wind. And then when we come back in tonight, well, about, we've got to be back here by 3. We should have the wind behind us, so that'll be good coming through the bar up there. Anyway, we'll get out there and get amongst it. I'll see yous on the road. So.
Rumors spreading round in that Texas town, that shack outside the Grange. You know what I'm talking about. Just let me know if you wanna go to that home outside the Grange. A couple of nice girls.
Yeah, see that.
Little reds.
Yeah, it's a nice
colour, mate.
Nice little
proper
fish for the day. Yeah. Nice work, Ryan.
Fodgy groups.
Yeah, I found them up at Telegraph.
Nice little blue one.
Yeah, it's a nice one. Beautiful colours. 52. 52 it is. Good job, mate. Ryan just scored a beautiful trout. Took it straight out of the jaws of a shark. Nice one, mate. Yeah, that's a proper one.
Proper trout. Good 60 model.
Well, we stayed out there for a bit, got a nice little mixed bag. It was bloody rough, the way everything was working. It was like a washing machine out there, so it was pretty shit actually. So we moseyed on back into shore and had a bit of a muck around in out of the weather.
This is what 50 k's out the sea is supposed to look like. Not the case.
Yours. Just down here, see if we can get a couple of jacks before evening comes. And the big storm in the back there, background there, all thundering away. So I wonder if we'll get any of that later on tonight. But my old mate brought me to this absolute
secret
beautiful
jackhole.
The favourite jackhole.
We haven't seen a jack yet.
We only just got here. So.
True. First bait.
Yeah.
Looks like a good spot. Great time to catch one.
Yeah. Especially with that storm in the background. I don't know if the camera's picking the rumbles up, but there's all rumble. Sounds pretty cool. Fair bit of breeze blowing. What do you reckon? 20, 25?
Yeah, I reckon.
Something around that?
About 3 times what they reckon.
Yeah. Yeah, we got smashed on the way home, eh? Man, I was crook as a dog. Anyway, must have been a bad dim sim, eh? Righto, if I catch something, I'll give you a gander at it. Righto, catch up.
Here we go, mate.
Oh, hang on. Oh.
Oh, Shane's on again here. What are we calling it for? Slightly small.
It might be a jack.
Slightly smaller jack.
estuary cod.
Oh, fucking shark.
Oh, joking. Put him in the pond.
Is that why I can't hook him?
Got a little collection here.
Big Jack, he's done it. He's got the one he's after, just smoked him, a big one smoked him before. Big Jack, mate, hey? Proper Jack. Nice one.
Beautiful.
Look at that, mate, that's a 45 every day of the week, isn't it? Paul Smith Jack. 45 straight off the bat.
Jack Jack.
He's got it. We knew they were here. Watch that hook on the ground.
How's those jaws when they open out, mate?
Look at that. Yeah, look good. I got some freezer. The light, mate.
Yeah.
Big Jack, mate. Big Jack.
Coming up through those clouds over there. Looks like there's a bit of a storm in that lot there, too. Been very quiet, haven't heard any rumbling for a while.
Not having any luck to.
We can't get him to
fucking head on again.
Bill Jackie?
Bill Jackie. I hope so. Yeah. Another nice one. Oh, yeah. I hooked him underneath,
too. Yeah, he's hooked good, though.
He's hooked good.
Yeah. Kimberley Mango Jack. Oh, that's a nice size. Look at the girth on that. Beautiful. Well done, mate.
Yeah, yours looks a bit fogged up.
Oh, it does, too. Hang on. That's better. Yeah, there's some nice colours in there, mate. Hey, doesn't get any better than that. Come down here. Just a head.
On a whiting head?
On a whiting head.
Finally got one. I've lost, missed about bloody dozen.
Good job, mate.
Yeah, you could have your second jack here. It hit it so hard.
Real hard.
Doesn't even know it's hooked, does it? Big jack.
Nice one.
Oh, yeah.
Another nice, Kimberley Jack.
I just lost one. This was about the 20th time. Oh, lucky we got Shane here tonight. Here we are. How's that for a sport? That'll bust you up. Good Jack in the sunset. So you don't get too much better than that. There's a few around, but they're pretty smart.
Yeah. That's a good chewing, Jack.
We'll be taking that for dinner.
For sure.
Don't they hit so hard?
Oh,
they don't muck around. They just
I got one. I've lost, missed about a bloody dozen.
Good job, mate.
Yeah. The old jackhole's produced.
Beautiful quality fish.
Slightly smaller. Yeah. We might let this one go. Okay. I don't know, what do you reckon?
Oh, well, we've got those two big ones. Well, you can put him in the pond and we
can upgrade. Put him in the pond, we'll upgrade.
we go, we're not going to have much light left, but small line, probably about 38, 40. They're hitting it harder now.
They're not fucking with it.
Possible. Taking me a while, but finally onto it.
I'm getting it. Catch and cook tonight.
Got a bit of jack. Oh, yeah.
Nice one.
Slightly smaller.
Yeah, still looks alright.
There's
a colour difference.
Wider one, slightly smaller.
Yeah.
We might let this one go.
Okay.
I don't know, what do you reckon?
Oh, well, we've got those two big ones. Well, you can put him in the pond and we can upgrade him.
He's on again.
In the pond.
Slightly smaller one.
Just getting the light.
Get me. Yeah, one little one to finish off before we're in darkness.
Beautiful.
A 30 job.
Good job, mate.
How good's that?
Another Kimberley wet season sunset. Ew. I just got another little estuary cod. I don't know if you guys can see him down there. Nothing to talk about. Oh, and that wind's dropped right out now too. But there's some beautiful colours there.
Got these guys running around all over the place at the moment. We had a decent amount of rain last night. Frill neck lizards. There you go, mate. Look at the way they run. Going all shy. You going all shy? Chum, 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 chum. Oh, I reckon they're classic. I was sitting on the chair last night, and out the corner of my eye, I seen this thing move, and it was one of them. It tried to run up me bloody leg, spilt me beer, and there was no one there to see it. Righto, tide's just on its way in now, heading out to the reef again. Hopefully it's not as rough as yesterday. I've taken myself a seasick bloody pill. Wouldn't read about it, eh? I never get seasick. Anyway, did yesterday. But today's another day, so we'll give it a crack. Do as well as we did yesterday, we'll be doing alright. Ready to go, old mate?
Yeah, mate, you ready when you're ready?
Yeah.
No rush.
All good.
Pissing in now.
Yeah. I don't think it's as bow as yesterday.
No. It should give me hope.
Or a different direction, mate. Seems to be
less
than you're ready. Yeah, that tide's racing in now, so we're out of here. I'll see you out on the open seas. We'll be right back.
just couldn't catch a break. That bloody wind came in. As soon as we got out there, basically, choppied the water right up. Sitting there on the pick was just absolute shit. We got another little mixed bag, wasn't too bad. And then we decided to call it quits and head back home. We'd gone north, this time. So we're heading straight back into it. And it just made for a very long trip back.
Oh, there you go. There's another fishing trip. Thanks very much for Ryan for inviting us down here. Showing us some good spots. We've got some good fish. When I put them on the filleting table, I'll give you all a look at what we got. Decent mixed bag there, actually. We've got this weather coming right in on us. Don't know if it's been raining up in front, up on this track. Time will tell. It's been right though. So we're, a couple of hours away from Broome, we'll be home. Alright, if anything happens along the way, I'll switch him on. Still,
big eagle sitting up here, guys. See if you can see him.
Good size. He's a beauty.
I think we're gonna miss it.
Big bolts of lightning coming out of that one right there.
Viewers, how you going? We made it all back, all good. A little bit of rain, not too bad. Road was wet on the way in, not worth filming too much. We got a heap of fish to clean, and we got the boat to clean and the car to clean. But I'll show you what fish we caught anyway. Here they are. Absolutely filthy boat. We tried to keep it clean as we're going. Having a good deck wash on board really helps. Now, if we didn't have that, she'd be a bloody lot dirtier in here. We caught a lot of fish. We didn't film all of them because it was bloody rough. Picking the camera up was just a nightmare. Ryan did really well from Ocean Addict. If you haven't checked his channel out, definitely go and do that because he's got some bloody good stuff on it. And he's a top bloke too. We got angles to clean. There's all sorts of shit. That was only, 2 days out there, and when you're fishing every day, it gets pretty gross. We got some nice ones in here. I'll get them right out, and they've been on ice overnight, so there's some beauties in there. So it's a lot easier, I find it a lot easier to fillet them when they've been on ice overnight. But we'll take them over to the cleaning area there, and give him a sort out. Well, that's pretty impressive in my books. Ryan caught a lot of these, of course. I got those Mango Jacks in that cod. And one of those little blue lines there, I think. he's taking some fish home as well, but he'll be going out in the next week or two, heading back out to another spot, so and I won't be. So this will feed our family for a while. Fish twice a week, can't wait. It's what we normally do. hate having the fish too long in the freezer. We like to get stuck into it and have it while it's nice and do it all sorts of different ways. So we've already cleaned on, sharpened our knives. So a quick on the diamond steel, just a little bit on the diamond steel, you better be careful with them. And then just touched up on the normal steel there, and you got yourself a razor sharp knife. Every now and then I break out the stone and put them on the stone and get the edge back. You've got to keep doing that, otherwise you won't have a sharp knife. So you should be able to shave with them, and then you know you've got a sharp one then. All good. All right, well, I'll get stuck into this. I won't bother you guys with all this because it's going to take a while. Anyway, you've seen all that before, haven't you? Righto, I'll get to work. So, I just thought I'd show you these blue bone fillets, how thick they are, how much meat you actually get out of one of these guys. It's like really thick right through. Absolutely awesome fish. No wonder we target them all the time. Beautiful. Righto, that's that lot all done. Bloody bowies are hanging around. That's just one lot. I've got to add two of these big plates. And Rennie's gonna cry pack them, and tonight we're gonna do the wings. So these are the wings, or some people call them the throats. And I'll show you how to cook them tonight, because I reckon they're the best bit. All those fins and that, I call them bush chips. Absolutely beautiful. All right, I've got to get this inside before these blowflies take me away. Got heaps of food for the pussycat. So that'll feed him for, what's there? It'll be close to a week. All right, I'll catch up. Okie doke. That's all the fish taken care of. That's all ready for cry packing tonight over a beer when Renee gets home. Now we need to sort this beast out. Had a few dramas over the weekend, don't know what happened there. Anyway, the transducer broke off, don't know how, waves maybe. But we managed to cable tie it up for now, it did the job. What was the other thing? Oh, the battery. The battery on the winch shit itself. Just when we were trying to bring it in too. So we had to try and hand, where is it? There it is. We had to try and hand winch it in, and the way that it's cogged out, you try hand winching this boat in. No bloody good. So we're gonna get a nice big fat battery to go in there. And hopefully that does the trick. Because you cannot hand winch this boat in. It's just, you need to be, I don't know what you need to be, but there was two of us doing it and we were busting a gut. And it's just the way it's cogged, I think. Anyway, we'll get that sorted. What else? Oh, the bloody sounder, the Furuno sounder. So if you want a Furuno sounder, give me a call and make an offer on it and you can bloody have the thing. I'm bloody over it. Where is it? Up there. That's a 10-inch screen. The GPS keeps dropping out on it all the time. So when you're trying to navigate back home and you can't bloody see anything, pain in the ass. Lucky we had a backup. We had two extra backups. Up this way, I think that's probably a necessary thing. But anyway, we got home. But I can't have that doing that, that's bullshit. And you need to be a bloody rocket scientist to bloody work the thing too. My brain's not equipped for that sort of bloody knowledge. I suppose a 5-year-old kid could use it. Doesn't say much for me, does it? But anyway, it's too hard to work. I'm going to get something else, something a bit more easier to control. So if anyone's got any ideas out there, for dumb bastards to use, let me know. Righto, I'm gonna get cleaning this thing. I'll probably be a good hour and a half cleaning the shit off out of this thing and give it a good tidy up. and then we can give the car a bit of a going over because she got a bit muddy going down that track, and it all is good. All right, guys, I'll get stuck into the work. You sit back on that lounge. Grab another beer. Zoop. Righto, guys, we're in the kitchen. We're going to knock a couple of sides off this jack and shallow fry it up. I made a seafood soup as well, which I'm going to drop these fillets into. Should be pretty bloody tasty. Next up, we're going to do these wings. So cleaned all the wings up, scaled them, got the oil out, dusted them in plain flour, pepper and salt, and then dropped them into a pretty hot wok. Rightio, I'm going to throw some of these in. Nice warm peanut oil. Actually, I tell a lie, it's rice bran. Bloody be careful doing this. One more. It'll be good. Are they the bizarrest things you've ever seen? Serve them up to your guests. I'm sure they'd ask, what the hell are they? But I assure you that they're tasty as. And they normally get thrown away, but there's so much meat in there. And each one of those fins are crispy, crunchy, beautiful. Try them out next time. Well, guys, that's all we've got for you today. Hope you enjoyed that. If you like that, please give us a thumbs up. If you subscribe and ring the bell, you'll be notified of the next mission. Thanks very much to Ryan for inviting us down the coast for a bit of a fish. Pity the bloody weather wasn't a bit better, but it is the middle of wet season. So can't do much about the weather, can you? Peter D from the Jets hand delivered a CD for me to use. So thanks very much to Peter. A lot of you WA boys would know the Jets from back in the day. Number one pub band. We went to them quite frequently. So thanks very much, Pete, for the soundtracks. Okay, that's all I got for you now. Catch yous up. Soup.